Is it military, working class, or a complex of a different kind? Just playing. So, a culture lesson in baldness. First, let me tell you a couple of the major reasons why people like myself would shave their head. Number one, it's because you're losing your hair and it looks better that way. So genetics, something you don't have control over. Also, people will shave their head for racial reasons, for reasons of unity, or just to make a statement by look. So, there's people like myself who just buzz their head because I've been losing my hair my whole life. I can't control it. And, you know, society tells you if you're balding, you're inferior, you can't get as well jobs, you won't get as many women, you won't make as much money. Pretty much everything's worse for you, period, if you're bald. It is, in America. You get no respect, and you're a piece of shit, you're a criminal, you're a racist, you're horrible. And so, that's one reason why you do it, to look better. It's clean, you know, it's easy to maintain as well. But if anybody tells you you'd rather buzz your head than grow out a full head of hair, they're a privileged retard. We know that. Okay, and then there's the people that buzz their head for racial reasons. Clearly there's the neo-Nazis would be one of the more famous ones. And, you know, so that's become a look too. That's a reason. And then you got those who are pretty boys, or it's a trend now where you got the Macklemore look, or somebody will buzz their head, you know, like lesbians or people to appear like they're fighting against something. And that's another reason. You also have the power, don't it? And that's the old person bald, where they can't let it go. They don't want to shave it off. But if that's any sign that white men who are bald can be rich someday, I'll take it. What else do you want to know? I guess where it starts. For white dudes, I noticed the balding usually starts in the crow's peak fashion. It starts right here. I had that when I was born. So I had the crow's peak or crow's feet or whatever the fuck you want to call it when you're born. But then black guys, I notice more often, in my personal observation, they start with the flying V, like in the, they get this notch in the top, in the middle, and then it goes out. And of course, you know, you got the different male pattern ball. This is lame even just talking about, but I figure somebody will find it interesting because y'all care about stupid shit on the internet, so why not? Being bald. So yeah, wear a hat, that helps. Wear a bandana. You definitely get your accessory game up when you go bald. You definitely find out how much more you think your outfit matters. Really doesn't, you just pay closer attention to it. It's like, who's gonna be smarter, tougher, more skilled, just an all-around greater person? Is it gonna be the one who is born with societal advantages or the one who wasn't? You just gotta think basically. You know, also, I have heard that bald people have more testosterone. It's a different type of testosterone that isn't necessarily linked to the sex drive, but it is linked to your hair loss, and I will take that one. And having observed these different types of, you know, fruits and vegetables, grains and starches, I wouldn't doubt it for a second that bald-headed people have bigger dicks than people with hair. I wouldn't doubt that at all. Another thing that is important to note, and I put this at the very end of the video for a reason, that historically, factors that have been tied to baldness include pollution, and radiation, and disease. So where are the most bald people? What are the most bald cultures? And why is that? If it's inferior in our society, there's no affirmative action talking about it. It's based on horrific things that have happened before and that still exist. It's just kind of this unspoken thing, isn't it? Like, ooh, he's that, you know? Does that remind you of something? And it's funny that I'm the bald head who looks like a Nazi and I'm the civil rights leader. Black Lives Matter, fuck you.